Right now, we're going to talk about DTI, what it is, how it works, and what you need to know as a borrower. My name is Drew Smith. I am a licensed loan officer at Mortgage Solutions Financial in Colorado. The first thing that we should do is define it. DTI stands for debt to income. So we've got two subjects here, two topics. That's your debts and that's your income. So first of all, before we break those two down, you have two types of DTI. You've got the front end and then you've got the back end. The front end is just going to be the house, just the mortgage. That's your principal and interest. On the back end, you're also going to include everything else. So it's the house plus the taxes, the insurance that you have on that house, and then it's going to be your debts. Now, debts are things that you are going to find on a credit report. So we'll get to that in a second. First, let's talk about income. A little bit about your income and calculating your income. There's a lot of rules and guidelines when it comes to different types of income, whether you're self-employed, W-2, 1099, things that come into play with those specific and different types of income. So the best way to calculate your income is to take your yearly gross income and divide that by 12. Now let's talk about debts. The debts that you're going to include in this DTI formula are going to be things that show up on your credit report. Not all debts are created equal, and you don't have to count everything in your debts, even if you are paying them on a regular basis. So the things that you are going to have to count and calculate are the things that show up on your credit report. These are going to be things like loans. So if you've got any other mortgages or possibly a car loan, it's also going to be any student loans or credit cards, things that are reporting to the credit agencies, the three separate credit bureaus. You could also include things on there like tax liens. You could have any other judgments if you've possibly been taken to court or something and there's a judgment. You could also include, and you will also include, any type of child support or alimony that you are ordered to pay. There are some different rules and guidelines with that. If you're not paying them for the next X amount of years, you could possibly not count those in your debts. There's debts that you don't necessarily have to count, even though you pay them on a regular basis. Things like utilities, cable, internet, Netflix. While you do pay them on a regular basis, you could technically or potentially cancel them at any time. So are they not counted against you in this DTI formula? Now the question is, how much can I go? What is the max DTI you can go and still qualify for a home loan? The general rule of thumb or guideline is 28% on the front end, 43% on the back end. You can go above that. It really just depends on the circumstance of each individual borrower. But if you have money in the bank, if you have reserves, that's in your favor, and you can go above that 43%, it also depends on the product that you're using. If you have a VA loan or a USDA loan, FHA, you can go higher than that 43% on the back end. Now I want to go through an example of how to actually do the math and calculate it. When you break it down into a math formula, it's DTI, so that's D/I, debt divided by income. So if you know your debts and you know your income, you can simply divide that and find it yourself. But let's go ahead and do a problem together here. So in this example, we're looking to purchase a $300,000 home. The final mortgage on that is going to be $1,750, okay, and that's going to be the back end, so that's going to be everything. That's the principal, insurance, taxes, and insurance, and interest. Then in this example, we've got a $300 a month car payment, and we've got a $100 a month credit card payment. Now, it doesn't matter how much that car costs. If that car costs $50,000, it doesn't matter. What matters is the monthly payment that I am obligated to on that monthly car payment. Same goes for the credit card or anything else that we're calculating here. So the total monthly payment that we have in debt is going to be $2,150, so $2,150. In this example, we make $60,000 a year. So you take $60,000, you divide it by 12, that is $5,000 a month. So again, you take your debt divided by your income, so that is $2,150 divided by $5,000, and that puts us on the back end right there at that 43%. So there you have it. You can calculate your own DTI. If you're out there shopping around and just want a quick, easy glance at your situation, that's the best way to do it. Just keep in mind that every situation is unique and dynamic. So just because you might calculate it and hit that 43%, doesn't mean that you're disqualified, okay? So my suggestion would be always reach out to a loan officer and get your unique situation looked at to see where you stand and what you would qualify for. Again, my name is Drew Smith. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me with Mortgage Solutions Financial.